Chapter 4 of Herland is called Our Venture. After their escape, the men travel by night and sleep by day to avoid detection. Finally, they can see their boat. However, they quickly discover that their plane is sewn into a cover. They have no way to cut it open, and soon discover that the same three women they first met, Alima, Celis, and Elidor, are there, watching them and giggling. Using what little they know of the women's language, the men try to explain their situation. They attempt to draw the women nearer and ultimately pursue them into the woods, but to no avail. They give up their chase and return to their plane, only to be met by their captors, whom they now refer to as the colonels. The men expect punishment. Instead, they're treated with civility and taken back in motorized vehicles, during which Van notes the beauty of the landscape. The men are taken through towns and villages, notably all without men or boys. When they are returned to their original room, the men are also told that they were watched during their escape, and that they are guests of the country who will eventually be allowed to move about freely when they've learned the language and agreed to do no harm. The men resume their language studies, though Van and Jeff are far more compliant than Terry. Terry is told that there haven't been men in the country for over 2,000 years. Two of the tutors explain that they reproduce without men, which Jeff explains is called parthenogenesis, virgin birth. One of the tutors expresses that she would like to read their history, to compare the history of 2,000 years to see what the differences are. When the subject of raising cattle for both milk and meat come up, the three tutors are shocked and horrified. The idea of parthenogenesis springs partly from Gilman's study of Lester Ward's essay, Our Better Halves. Ward suggested that women are rightly the ones who should have more power and influence in society. Its place in Herland also underscores the idea that motherhood, even amongst animals, is central to this country and its people. By the end of the novel, it's clear that everything in this society springs from the idea of motherhood. Education, conservation of resources, fitness, everything serves to ensure the survival and protection of the next generation. This ideal of service for the good of the community creates a peaceful, non-competitive, non-destructive environment.